Hello, hello, baby, you called, I can't hear a thing. I have got no service in the club, you say, say. What did you say? Oh, you're breaking up on me. Sorry, I cannot hear you, I'm kinda busy.
Your big home run there. Well, I mean,
I got my pitch tonight. She pitched me up and in, and that is my pitch to hit. Mm-hmm. I just got lucky. It was perfect.
No, I know, it was perfect. You hit it nicer there. Just tell me about overall, this team really seemed to hit the ball well today.
We worked really hard on hitting the past couple of weeks because hitting's been struggling, mm-hmm. but our defense is solid. So we focused on hitting because we knew hitting wins ball games, and we did it tonight.
Are you, I mean, this is two undefeated teams. You had a good team over there in Katy, but are you a little surprised that it was this lopsided, or are you just kind of just going along to say that's how it breaks?
I honestly, we were the better team. We get along better. We mesh well together. We work together.
Mm-hmm.
We're just all around a team, and they didn't have it.
Talk about adjusting to Coach Miller, you know, and everything this whole season, because Coachy changed in the middle of the school year. It's kind of stressful, but you guys seem to have bonded well and worked it out.
Coach Miller's got to be the best thing that's happened to us this season. He knows the game. He loves us like daughters.
Mm-hmm.
We love him like a father. He's best coach ever.
That's excellent. Good job. So what do you feel like you guys are going to next? I know you got a tough game against Taylor next. I mean, how are you going to try and build off of this big win here?
We're just going to do the same thing we always do. Practice hard and play as a team.
All right. Sounds good, Amy. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Hey, thank you.
Talk about your hitting. After the home run, you hit another one off deep.
Yeah.
Did you think that was going over too?
Oh, kind of. I didn't hit it in the right spot, so I was better run on this one.
So what are you looking forward to as far as coming up against Taylor next week?
I just play as a team, win, beat him.
Well, good luck to you.
I'm not afraid of the dark.
Awesome game for you guys. I mean, to go in against a team that's undefeated in the district to get this win, you got to be happy for you.
Well, we're an undefeated team, too.
Oh, that's true.
We were undefeated, too, and, you know, our kids have been playing well. And we'd only given up one run in district play, and that was unearned against Seven Lakes. So we knew if we could get a few runs on the board and you know, settle down and play defense and, you know, get two runs in the first inning and two runs in the second inning, let us breathe a little bit. And
I guess you got saved.
Yes. But, you know, this is a big win because that's a quality program. They're going to be a quality program. And as long as Caleb Mack is coaching that club over there, those kids are going to play hard. They're going to play the game the right way. But, you know, our kids, you know, once we figured out how Coach Miller wanted to play, and they you know, early in the season, I was kind of figuring them out, and they were kind of figuring me out. But once we got to district play, we've been playing well. And hey, I couldn't be prouder this much because they played as a team. They've done things right. They practice hard. They stick together. They have a great time playing. So, you know, I couldn't be prouder. But, you know, here we got to start over again with Taylor. And like we told them, we're going to enjoy this win tonight, but we got to get ready to play Coach Powell's team on Friday. And, and they're going to be ready because Coach Powell's a great coach. It's a tough district for softball.
It
so
is.
Everyone we play, you know, you got to come ready to play or you're going to lose.
Hey, what else you can say about Kristen Emily? I mean, pitcher.
Well, I mean, she's composed. She's mature. She's got a great understanding on how to pitch. You know? And she doesn't have the fastest fastball, but she understands how to pitch. Get ahead, stay ahead, and put them away. And you know, we help her a little bit with our defense, and you know, we score some runs, and that makes pitching easier. It's an all around thing. But Kristen's done a great job for us.
And just talk about offensively, to explode like that, you know, get a couple of runs, and then next inning get some under, you know, got some, took a capitalize on some errors, and then a 3-run homer.
Well, I mean, we'd like to consider ourselves a solid program. Most solid programs really work on taking advantage of what the other team gives you. And making sure, and we talk to our kids a lot about centering the ball up and using the middle of the field. Not pulling off the ball, staying on the ball, letting it get to the plate, all those things that, you know, good hitting teams do. And we were fortunate tonight that, you know, we put the ball in play and then we got some big hits. Put some big hits on the ball.
Do you guys feel that this is a statement win for you guys?
I'll let you guys in the media determine whether it's a statement or not. It's a win for us, and it doesn't mean anything unless we come back and put another win on the board Friday. So I mean, that's a good team. We were fortunate to come over and play maybe our best game of the season. But you know, we'll go back to work tomorrow and get ready for Taylor on Friday.
Well, I mean, they hit the ball. They play defense and. Like I said, they were just a much better team than we were today. I don't think we're ready to play. I mean, there's no reason we shouldn't be because it was the biggest game we've had all season long, and they're just a better team than we are right now.
So what's the next step for you guys? What you got to work on to try and get back to where you got to do on Friday?
I think, you know, the girls, we're just talking here in the huddle, and that we've just got to be a little bit more mature competitively than we have been all season long. So we've got to get some young players that are going to have to step up. We've got to get a lot tougher than we are right now. And we just got to do a better job.
Hey, we know about the Cinco Katy rivalry in the football. And we know it rolled over into basketball a little this season. You think it's going to now take off in softball for you?
I think it's been in softball for a while. Especially when we played them for the regional finals, and they're shaking their keys and holding their signs up to go to state, and we hit a home run to tie it up in the bottom of the seventh, and so from that point forward, it's been the rivalry in our district.